What's up, everybody? I hope everybody's having a great day today. First off, I want to make sure you hit that subscribe button or give me a thumbs up and a comment below if you like this channel, guys. Let me know what videos you like to watch and what videos you want to see more of. In today's video, we're going to talk about one of the most important subjects of our time, of our generation, and the most important thing that we all need to roughly focus on right now. We all have things that we need to do in our lives, guys, but on the bigger, grand scheme of humanity, these are the things that we need to be working on. Today, we're going to be talking about global warming, guys. And I know some people still feel like, oh, maybe it's not real, but they've been telling us this for years, guys. The statistics are there. The facts are there. Everything supports the fact that we need to make a change, guys. We really need to start doing things differently, creating things differently, and living a more sustainable life for ourselves and for the planet. So today I'm going to talk about 10 different ways that you can reduce your impact on global warming. We all need to work together and do what we can in our communities, individually, and as a state and as a nation to really combat these things, guys. It's going to take all of our help. That's what we're here for. We're here to take care of the planet, guys, and we lost sight of that. And we really need to get back to the place where we're all working together and being conscious of what we do to make sure that the planet is as healthy as possible. Because once we lose that, it's it, guys. Can't get it back. These are 10 ways that you individually can help combat global warming. Number one is to push for reduced methane emissions from your town, your state, and your country, guys. Methane is one of the number one reasons for global warming, guys. Methane can be emitted from fracking. Methane can also be emitted from factory farming, guys, from cows, and from mass production of meat products. Methane gas is responsible for 1/4 of the global warming changes. Push your local and national governments to reduce and eliminate methane emissions, guys. Cutting methane is one of the cheapest and easiest ways that local and national governments can reduce climate change. Number two is renewable energy. Depending on where you live, it might be more accessible and easier in certain places. And the more I hope that we get more technology and more resources to work on these projects, they will be more accessible to you in your town and your nation. We really need to change our energy source to solar, wind, and water as much as we can, guys. Number three, green your commute. We have so many more options now. You can start walking, guys, riding a bike, use an electric skateboard, an electric scooter. Try to switch to electric or hybrid vehicles and try to reduce flying as little as possible. Elon Musk, we're waiting on your electric jet, man. That will help tremendously. Number four, use your energy wisely. Small changes can really add up. Change to energy efficient light bulbs. Unplug your computers, TVs, and electronics when you're not using them, guys. Hang dry and air dry as much as you can. Dryers are energy hogs and use dryer balls. Install a programmable thermostat so you can change your energy usage during the day depending on how much you need it. Look for an Energy Star label when buying your new products, guys. This lets you know that these are energy efficient and clean for the environment. Try to winterize your home to prevent heat from escaping so you don't have to use as much energy to heat your house, guys, in the wintertime. Number five, put a price on pollution. Now, this is not a popular idea, but putting a carbon tax on all the carbon emissions that we use could really help benefit the planet, guys. If we have an incentive to not use it more, then we're more apt to not use that energy source or waste it like we have been in the past. Push your local and state governments to put a price on pollution. Consume less, waste less, and enjoy life more, guys. We need to get back on focusing on life's simple pleasures. Spend more time in nature. It doesn't cost anything. It doesn't use any energy. It's great for everybody and everything, guys. Be with your loved ones. Instead of spending money and using energy all the time, enjoy time with your loved ones, your friends, and your family. That's what we really need to get back to. Making a difference. Go help in your community, guys. Go help out when needed. Go help others. These are ways that you can detach from the electronics and the things that are using all this energy all the time. Doing these things provides your life with more happiness and purpose instead of consuming and buying more goods. Sharing, making, fixing, upcycling, repurposing, and composting are all good ways to start. Number seven, divest from fossil fuels and invest your money where they are investing in our environment and our future. We really need to get away from gas-powered vehicles, and anything that uses fossil fuels, guys. That's what's killing our planet right now. You don't want to be an investor in a dying industry anyways. It's time to invest in your and your planet's future. Number 8. Invest in renewable energy. Invest your money and time into renewable companies and co-ops. Number 9. Eat for a climate-stable planet. These are some simple diet changes that you can make to reduce your impact on climate change. Eat meat-free meals. Guys, I know it's not popular. A lot of the places in the United States, out of the country, we're born and bred with this idea that we need meat, bread, milk, cheese, potatoes. But that's not true, guys. The more you can get to a vegan, vegetarian diet, the better it is for your health and our planet. There's so many meatless options out there, guys. There's new ones coming up every day. Try some. Give it a try. Give yourself a week where you go meatless and really see how it makes you feel and changes your mood, your mindset, and your health. Buy organic and local, guys. Support these companies and these local people that are supporting organic and locally grown foods. Don't waste your food. If you're not going to eat that much, don't take that much. We need to really conserve what we're using and consuming on a daily basis. Grow your own food. It's easy, it's awesome, and it's cheap. With technology expanding, there's so many new ways that you can grow your own food easy and cheap and in your own home. Eating no or less meat will reduce the methane emissions produced by factory farming and meat-producing animals. Number 10. Tell your story. People are influenced the most by example. I'm a firm believer in that. Spread your story and the changes that you've noticed in your life and those lives that are around you. Encourage your friends and family to take part in saving the planet too. We can do this, guys. I have faith in us, I have faith in humanity, and I have faith that we can realign the planet where it needs to be with climate change, with our health, with anything that's ailing us right now. Our most important goal as a human, as a society, is to take care of this planet and that we're headed to a balanced, stable future. I hope you enjoy this video, guys, and you can apply these examples in your life to help save the planet, guys. It's us. We can do this. We need to work together and build a strong, balanced world. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe, hit a comment, and a thumbs up below, guys. Let me know if there's other ways that I missed that we can all help come together to save the planet.